Hey guys, my name is Sigalan. I work for Precious Plastic. I'm a mountaineer and we are today in Kathmandu, the capital of Nepal. In this episode, we will follow the path of the plastic in the Everest Base Camp region, the highest mountain of the world, home to the Sherpa community. Over 80,000 tourists visit this remote valley every year. As you can imagine, this has a cost and a weight on the local communities as well as on their ecosystems. Join us to understand how tourism impacts an isolated community and its ecosystem. But most importantly, to understand and to get to know the organizations that are tackling this challenge. The Art and Education Center Sagarmatha Next in Namshibasar, as well as the small-scale plastic recycling workspace Movare in Kathmandu. Let's go. Welcome to the remote Everest region. It is accessible only via foot or air, as there are no roads. For many years, it has been drawing people from all over the world who come for long journeys to see the highest mountain of the world. The demand of tourism has increased the needs of goods high up in the mountain: food, beverages, clothing, gear, and much more. All transportation modes are used: airplanes, helicopters, porters, donkeys, and yaks. The Sherpa culture and the landscapes is what drives the people. Unique traditions of the Buddhist religion and their interesting methods to find internal peace. Stunning peaks that move mountaineers to beat records and push their limits. As well as the beautiful ecosystems where animals and plants have adapted to extreme conditions and the new human interactions in the mountains. And of course, the majestic Everest. But let us not forget, despite its apparent isolation, the Khumbu Valley is also faced with the harsh reality of waste and is affected by plastic pollution. Many goods go up, but very few go down. This reminds us of the dark shadow of plastic and the urgency to take action. We are now in Namshibasar, a village in the center of the Sherpa culture at over 3,500 meters. This village is a perfect place for trekkers or mountaineers to do their acclimatation stop before heading up to the mountain. Right above this village, on the top of the hill, there is an art and education center called Sagarmatha Next. Let's go and visit it.
Welcome to Sagarmatha Next. That is the name of this center that we're standing inside right now. My name is Tommy Gustafsson and I'm one of three co-founders of this center. The whole purpose of this activity up here at 3,800 meters in the Khumbu Valley on the way to Everest is basically to work with the local organization here called SPCC, Sagarmatha Pollution Control Committee, to try to implement a system where we take care of the waste, sort the different materials, bring them to facilities where we can process them in to make volumes smaller. So basically shred plastic bottles, bale different metal cans, and then package them into a solution for the transportation, which we call CarryMeBack. CarryMeBack is a bag about this big, and it weighs around 1 kilo once it's filled with up to 20 bottles that are shredded or 20 cans that are baled. And then we use the movement of all the visitors and the tourists that comes to this region, and everybody goes up to see Everest, of course, but then they also go back. And that movement is what we use to transport as much as possible out from the region back to Kathmandu, where we do have some recycling capacity.
following a month in the high mountains and a very interesting visit with Sagarmatha next, we will go and see where the bottle caps brought down from these mountains are processed to make a collection of souvenirs, Himalayan stones, and a model of Everest. Let's go! Eva is the director of Movari, mountain waste repurpose, which has been recycling since 2013, working with different materials, paper, glass, and today, plastic. She is a key person in making this recycling possible and will show us how they process the bottle caps into new precious souvenirs. Much for having us. It's been so nice to understand what you guys do here, how you guys work with the plastic, and what Moware, Sagarmatha Next, and the SPCC have done as a project in collaboration. It's been really incredible. We want to ask you two final questions.
Sure.
One, which is, how much plastic have you guys collected since you've started? In what period of time?
Through Karimi Ba, we have, until last season, we brought down 12,000 kgs.
Okay.
I think this season will be another 4,000 kgs, but this includes PET, aluminum, and the bottle caps. Mm-hmm. And at Movari, the amount of plastic we have recycled since May 2022 until date, making these products, is around 250 kg.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's great. And how many pieces have you produced in or with Sagarmatha Next?
I would say around 3,500 right now.
Wow. Yeah. And still growing, I imagine.
The people are loving the product and we keep selling more and more. So now we are also getting more equipment and more molds because we need to increase the production capacity.
Wow, yeah. That's really great. Well, we wish you all the best in the future. We really hope that people will continue to come to Sagarmatha Next, that will continue to buy the products that you make and continue to raise awareness around the problem of waste that you have in the Khumbu region, but which is a problem that's global to the world. And we really hope that anyone who's out there looking at this video, if you know of a workspace that does an innovative or has an innovative solution when it comes to collecting waste or who operates in remote area, please put in the comment. We would love to see more workspaces like this one. Thank you very much for watching.